Welcome back to Gundar Tutorials. Today we don't have a closer look at the surrounding here of the world tree. Also not on this side, but we focus here in the craftsman's quarter on the sawmill. More specific, on this watermill. So you see, Minecraft is more or less a bit of a static game, and every piece which we could animate is a great piece. So here you can see this moving watermill, and that's something which I would like to show you how to do. The basic idea of this redstone contraption is that we have a block which is moving basically around a single centerpiece. So this one. So most of these blocks would be filled with a block, and then there would be one empty piece. And if these pistons are synchronized well enough, then it moves quite smooth and solid. So what to do is we can first of all place this centerpiece. This is like the where we then see where to put down the pistons, because well, here would be the first one. It pushes the pistons up. Then we would need here another one on this position, so it can push the blocks on this side. Then we would need one exactly on this position. So this block, this piston can now push the blocks down again. And then the final one is here down in the left lower corner. So this is basically the setup for the pistons, which you can also already see over there. Now it really depends on how much space you have in your base. Ooh, what's that? The end, as it seems. Well, we are in the test area, as you can see. It's a bit strange. But yes, anyway, you have, I guess, a bit of a certain space which you can use, and we basically need two redstone components. First of all, a clock, which gives a repeated signal out, and the other is the correct timing for these blocks. So let's first build our clock, maybe over here. As I said, it totally depends on how much space you have in your build. So for the clock, we use a comparator. Then we can use an output signal, link it up, and then you get already this this pulse which we need then for the that these here trigger in a correct cycle. Now it's time to get this pulse signal to our pistons. And they have to fire like this one first, second, third, fourth, first, two, three, four, and so on. So they have to fire in a quick succession. So also to cover all these components up, we can first, for example, place here a lock block behind it. And then we have to power this component such that this component here activates. Now, to cover all the ongoing redstone stuff up, we can also hide it a bit. So you could, for example, build here a wall behind it. Of course, you have to leave out the gaps where the redstone signal should be going through. But something like this could work out quite well. So now you have, well, this can also be hidden behind the wall where you don't see anything left. And later on, we can build a bit of a nicer surrounding to it. But first of all, we have to get this whole contraption working. Now let's get to the wiring. So we have now our signal, which is a pulse. And now we have to just link the signal up with our different pistons. And we say, let's see. This here will be the first one, the second one, the third one, and this is the fourth one. Actually, this is the first one. Yeah. Let's do, this is the first one which fires, then this is the second one, the third one, and the fourth one. So, now let's get our signal here back to the site. And for these to fire differently, we just link them up with a different number of repeater. So here we just plug in one, here we plug in two, then here we plug in three, and down here we basically plug in four. And this already helps us to that this fires the first, then this the second, third, and fourth. And this in a quite good succession. So of course, we now just have to link them up. And we can basically now put them into, link them up to the our very own redstone signal, which we have now going on. So something like this down here, and then here the last one should fit in very well. You can also see that this one here is quite simple. There's not much logic behind. It's just that it's, well, this is the first, second, third, and fourth part. Now having the piston action working, let's see if it's actually working. So for that, you can use whatever block you want for the spinning wheel. You could go, for example, for screws lock here. And then you, what you have to do is to basically insert them into the system until you have a running system here. Maybe it's also a bit special. Yeah, you have to figure out in which side you have to insert these blocks so that it works. So that should be enough, and then one more, and the last one, and perfect. Now you have the spinning kind of effect, which we need for the spinning wheel, and yeah, you can see if you imagine the water pouring in, and you get this nice water wheel effect. Of course, it's a water wheel without water would be a bit strange, so we can now make the bit of the styling. And what I did is that the water poured in here. You could either pour it in on this spot or on this spot. For my one, for my version, I have it in this direction. And it's also no problem because the water won't flow out here. It's just going down. So it could be flowing down and then into this block. And then you can basically make a water source up here. So let's do that. Put in a bucket of water. And then now it's flowing here at the back. And it feels a bit like that the water actually gives this spam, this wheel, the spin. Of course, I've also done this surrounding with the fence. So that it looks a bit more secure. And of course, you can maybe get rid of these blocks here so that we can also cover it up with something else. For example, you could use stone or whatever material you would like for your bottom part. And then for the sides, also something to cover it up, maybe some lock blocks. And for the front, also some connecting one. And now you already got this really nice spinning effect for your water mill. And then, well, the rest didn't basically get here well because the redstone is covered from behind, so no water can't affect it. It's all hidden, and that's quite perfect. So at the end, just one more thing. Maybe you don't want that this water mill is here running 24/7, so it would be great to have some sort of a lever. So let's put one down instead of the red of the redstone block here. You could also have a line going in. Let's see. Yeah, it should work. So just have to be careful that this line here is not longer than 16, or you have to put down another repeater. But you can see if you have then now this lever going on, then it's activated. If you deactivate it, then it's stopping at one point. And this should also be the default section. If you now activate it again, then it should start running. And whenever you deactivate it, it should end up in the very same default position. So let's put it on again. Get into the viewer mode here. And so I hope you like this small little Redstone tutorial about actually some animation which is going on in Minecraft. And it really looks cool and it gives it a bit more touch to your style. So next time, if you want to build a water mill, then maybe consider this one. Also, be sure to hook up some levers that you can deactivate it, because of course, as all Redstone components, it takes a bit of server resources. But this time shouldn't be too bad. Except the noise it makes. But well, it's for example a sawmill, and sawmills make noise. So, not much else to say then. Thank you for watching. Please leave a like, please leave a comment, and also spread the word. Would be happy to get even more of you to know what we do here on Gundar. Would be great. So, not much else to say then. See you in the next one. Ciao!